Welcome to Science Store online classes.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello students. Today we shall continue with the chapter Some Basic Concepts of Chemistry. In this chapter we have already dealt with what is matter, three states of matter and classification of matter. Now today let's learn about properties of matter. Properties of matter. Properties of matter are unique, and matter has characteristic properties. Properties of matter are classified into two types. So we have two types of properties. They are physical properties and chemical properties. There are two types of properties for matter. They are physical and chemical properties. We shall now see what is a physical property and what is a chemical property. So let me take up physical properties. Physical properties are those which can be observed or measured without changing chemical identity. Without changing chemical identity or without changing chemical composition of substance. Such property is called physical property. Physical properties can be observed or measured without changing chemical identity of substance. Which are the examples for the physical properties? Example, boiling point of a substance. That is, you are measuring the temperature at which liquid boils, that is boiling point, melting point, solubility, all these are the different physical properties. So in order to measure the physical property or in order to observe it, the chemical composition or chemical identity of the compound need not be changed. Such properties are physical properties. The substances exhibit chemical properties also. Let's see what is meant by chemical property. These chemical properties can be observed or measured only if chemical change take place. That means, in order to measure chemical property, chemical changes must take place in matter. That is, chemical composition must change. The chemical reaction should occur. Only then we can measure the chemical properties or we can observe them. Some of the chemical properties are acidity of the substance, basicity of the substance, oxidizing nature. These are all some of the examples for the chemical properties. So, matter has two types of properties, physical properties and chemical properties. Physical properties can be measured without changing the chemical composition or chemical identity of the substance. But in order to observe chemical properties, we have to change the chemical identity of the substance, means chemical reaction must take place. Now, whenever we measure the physical properties, they are expressed by a unit and a number. Normally, physical properties are indicated or expressed by number followed by unit. Normally, whenever physical properties are measured, it is expressed by using a number which follows a unit. Units of measurement earlier used are two types. Mainly two types of units of measurement were used. There are two systems. One is a metric system and the second one is English system. Units of measurement in olden days and now also few unit systems are used. They are important two types, metric system and English system. Metric system is given by France. English system is also called as a British system. So in different places of world, different units of measurement were used. In order to have common units of measurement, now what we have is SI system. So next let us learn about SI units. SI units. What is SI units? It is a international system of units. International system of units given by IEPs. SI system is international system of units. There are seven basic or fundamental units in SI system given for seven fundamental physical properties. There are seven basic or fundamental units. Which are they? Let's see now. So let's take up the seven basic fundamental units. They are first, I'll take the physical quantity. Second column, I'll take symbol of quantity. Then I'll take up SI unit and symbol of unit. There are seven basic units in under SI units. They are, first one is mass. Mass is represented by the symbol small letter m. Unit given for mass is kilogram. Kilogram is represented as kg. K small, g small here. Second one is length. Length is indicated by the symbol L. Unit for this is meter. Symbol used for meter is small letter m. Third one is time, indicated by the symbol small letter t. Unit used for this is second. It is denoted by the symbol small letter s. Fourth one is thermodynamic temperature, or simply you can call it as temperature. Thermodynamic temperature or temperature. Symbol used for this is capital letter T. The SI unit for this is Kelvin. Symbol used is capital letter K. Fifth one is amount of a substance. It is denoted by the symbol small letter N. Unit used for this is mole, M-O-L-E. Symbol used for this is M-O-L. Last letter E is not written, just M-O-L, mole. Sixth one is electric current. Electric current is indicated by the symbol capital letter I. SI unit for the electric current is ampere, which is denoted as capital letter A. And seventh fundamental physical quantity is luminous intensity. Luminous intensity. It is denoted as IV. V is a subscript here. Unit used for this is candela. It is abbreviated as CD. See, these are the seven basic SI units. Let's go through the table now. For mass, unit is kilogram, abbreviated as kg. Length, SI unit is meter, denoted as small letter m. Time, SI unit second, denoted as small letter s. Thermodynamic temperature, SI unit is Kelvin, denoted as capital letter K. Amount of substance, unit is mole, symbol is also mole, it is denoted as MOL. Electric current, unit is ampere, denoted as capital letter A. Luminous intensity, SI unit is candela, denoted as CD. These are the seven basic units given for the seven fundamental quantities, from which units of other physical quantities are obtained or they are generated. Now, students, we all know whenever we express the length, sometimes we tell the length in meters, sometimes we tell it in centimeters, we can also tell the length in millimeters. You have seen this, you have applied this also. Even the mass, for some substances we express the mass in kilogram, for few we express in grams, for few substances we express in milligrams, nanograms, etc. What is this milli, centi, nano, etc. stand for? They are prefixes used for these symbols of the units, or for these physical quantities. The prefixes used are milli, centi, nano, etc. Now let us study about prefixes for the SI units. Let's take up prefixes. What prefixes indicate? They are multiples or submultiples of units. They are multiples or submultiples of units. These multiples or submultiples of units are given as power of 10. Now let's take the multiples and submultiples used. Let's take up some prefixes. Multiples. And symbols used for this. I'll take the first column as a multiple. Let's take the second column as prefix. And symbol used for these prefixes. 10 to the power minus 1 is a multiple. Prefix used for this is deci. It is denoted by the symbol small letter d. 10 to the power minus 2 is centi. 10 to the power minus 2 is centi. It is denoted by the symbol small letter c. 10 to the power minus 3, prefix is milli, denoted by the symbol small letter m. 10 to the power minus 6 is micro, denoted as mu. While writing it looks like u, read as mu, mu. 10 to the power minus 9, it is nano, denoted as small letter n. 10 to the power minus 12, it is pico, denoted by the symbol p. 10 to the power minus 15, it is called as femto and also known as fermi, denoted as f. 10 to the power minus 18 is atto, A-T-T-O, denoted by the symbol small letter A. 10 to the power minus 21 is zepto, denoted by the symbol small letter Z. 10 to the power minus 24 is yocto, denoted by the symbol small letter Y. Look at these multiples. Here the power of 10, what you have seen, is negative power. Initially 10 to the power minus 1, deci. 10 to the power minus 2, centi. 10 to the power minus 3, milli. After that, powers differ by 3 units. 10 to the power minus 6, micro. 10 to the power minus 9, nano. 10 to the power minus 12, pico. 10 to the power minus 15, femto or fermi. 10 to the power minus 18, atto. 10 to the power minus 21, zepto. 10 to the power minus 24, yocto. These are all negative powers of 10 for which the prefixes are given. Let's take few more prefixes. Let's take 10 to the power 1. For 10 to the power 1 is called as deca. It is called as deca. 10 to the power 1 is nothing but 10. The prefix used for this is DA, small letter D, small letter A. 10 to the power minus 1 is deci. 10 to the power minus 2, 10 to the power minus 2 is centi. Now I'll take 10 to the power plus 2. 10 to the power plus 2 is hecto, represented as H. 10 to the power plus 3 is kilo, represented as a small letter K. 10 to the power plus 6 is mega, denoted by capital letter M. 10 to the power 9 is giga, denoted by capital letter G. 10 to the power 12 is tera, denoted by capital letter T. 10 to the power 15 is peta, denoted by capital letter P. 10 to the power 18 is called as exa, denoted by capital letter E. 10 to the power 21 is zeta, denoted by capital letter Z. 10 to the power 24 is yotta, denoted by capital letter Y. So these are the prefixes which indicate multiple or submultiples of units. Go through these. We have negative powers of 10 and we also have positive powers of 10. In this column, normally we make use of deci, centi, milli, micro, nano, pico, femto. In positive powers, we make use of deca, hecto, kilo. These are the generally used multiples and submultiples of units.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.